to start doing the same thing. But you know, this person's not here, I don't know what. Stay focused, we need to get paid. So you have to be very careful with the safety of debtors. They'll give the same excuses on daily basis. Come, Madam, I say, to the point you feel Goma is lying, but you cannot do anything about it. So please, stay focused. Let him tell your lies, but tell him that you need to collect the money, you need to get our payment. Simple as that. We are tired of excuses, we need our payments. Incidental letter, we say, these letters are unable to handle their obligations due to life occurrences, such as job loss, change in marital status, kiwango kaniacha, natural disaster, sickness, or personal injury. And with this, we said to recognize these types of letters, the issue was like condition of the economy, everyone is suffering. My wife left me. I've been in the hospital for 2 weeks. This is too much money and so on. So this was an incidental letters. And sometimes they're serious, but it's just that we tend to use that as our excuse for not meeting our obligations. You go into farming like in a company, then they tell you, our MD has traveled. That has nothing to do with your payment. You ask them, are you getting your salaries? If he has traveled, then why don't you close the offices? Yeah. So we say professional collector will focus on showing them the consequences of not paying as they make end promises. Come, listen. You have been saying it's because your wife left you. If it's an individual, but this debt has interest. The longer it stays with the empty promises, the more it will become difficult for you to pay. So I might go back today thinking, Kwamba, it's okay, I understand your problems, but you need to make efforts so that the consequences does not affect you. If it's a company, it's the same way. That today you're telling me your end is not here, end is not there, but if you take other measures, even company might get closed. And this might, you might even lose your job in the end. Because we need to stay in the business. We're your biggest suppliers. So you might give me these excuses, it's fine, I can wait. But in the long run, the consequences will not be very good to you as a person or the company as a whole. So we tell them, the consequence appeal shows data, the benefits of paying the debts, and make sure they know the consequences of non-payment. And this is where Empower will tell you, we'll register you, we'll credit info, I don't know, we can do this, we can do that. But the problem is, how is the consequence affecting that person individually? Do you understand that? So you have to make sure, Bamba, when you appeal to the consequences to this incident letter, you actually know, Bamba, the consequences can have impact on his life or his organizations. And that's why I use the words like reputation, for example. You must mean you tell your clients, Bamba, with the reputation, if people hear that you don't pay, it might damage your business. And people might think, yes, it will click, okay. If my biggest customer hears that I'm not paying, then they might think, Kwamba, I'm a cheater. So they say, let's keep it down, let's work on the account. Okay? Come on, individuals, don't tell the consequences and buzzwords in the manner. Tapuleka police, so what? Because a person who understands the number of police, are going to, so what? You frustrate them. Because you give them the consequences and bio, it will appeal to their emotions. Kwa sisi, kuna one of the messages to what we attended to Pandia, utadisikiaje, I hope you understand this, eh? Utadisikiaje kama ndugu zako labda watu wako karibu wakaona matangazo kwenye vyombo vya habari madaiwa. Hii kitu inaweza kukaribia kazi, utu wako, familia, you understand, eh? Kwa hela ndogo sana ambayo you can pay ndani ya dakika tano. Tafadhali lipa kuogopa fedha. When you said that out, do you know what happened? Everyone started paying.
Wow.
Some people, it abuses the emotions.
Yeah.
Mtu ni mke, if it's a missus, your wife, she's thinking, what if my husband knows I'm indebted to this company?
Yes.
Then the type of husband, the ones who don't ask for answers, they'll beat for answers. Then they'll say, no, I have to pay before. Yeah. If a person works at the bank, ethics of the bank, you are not supposed to have an outstanding balance that you're not paying. You're not supposed to be defaulting. go to the bank. So this person goes to the bank, then they feel that if my employer learns that I'm indebted, let's say to Branch International, then it may damage my working relationship. They'll come and they'll pay. So you appeal to the emotions, you make them realize the consequences. You don't threaten them, but you make them realize the consequences. So in this letter, it works as well. Come back, you may have a problem, maybe your wife left you, it's fine, but the consequences can be damaging. Sorry, man. Intellectual letter, one of my favorites. We say, this type of letter does not deny the existence of this obligation, which arose from previous transactions. When you go to them, there's a certain task. Yeah, no, 10 million and 500,000, right? Yes. Yeah, the ones that we took from last week. Yeah? Yes, I know that. They're always like that. This type has a number of reasons kept an excuse, which explain why you cannot pay your time. So you come up with an excuse, I've been working on your document. I know the full amount of everything. And they are very savvy when it comes to credit use and collection practices. Savvy, what it means is, they are aware, they know every process. Come at the bank, they know your banking process, they know your loopholes, they know the legal implications, they know everything. You cannot tell them anything. You cannot even threaten them. For you, we say, the use person like, where is the LPO? I'm not denying, giving the LPO a pay, and he knows he has not given it the LPO.
They have done that conversation by phone or by email.
Regardless, you give them the conversation via email, and they tell you, we need the help. Our organization does not pay via without help. They'll say, I need my contract. Oh, I don't know you. So you don't have the help, and there's a standing balance between what you do. That's where you bring again your emotional intelligence. You bring everything that you have, you put that on the table. So no matter what you say, the profit of letter directs the debtor in the best direction to go. First, by asking questions against the debtor to understand that they, as the debtor, must make a plan and stick to it. So you can tell them, for example, I don't have the LPO, but in normal circumstances, you are the one issuing the LPO. Don't you have a copy in your systems? So you can start, by the way, do you normally file LPOs when issue? They say, well, yes, for us we keep all the records. And I'll be okay. You're the one who issued the LPO. Don't you have a copy in your system? No. Don't you have a copy?
Same happened,
Stanbic
Bank.
Yeah.
Stanbic Bank, CMC Automobile. CMC Automobile.
Stanbic Banks are.
They're not paying.
They are not paying, and they want the LPO, all the supporting documents, but we don't actually, unfortunately. So missing, we don't know where. Every time give the invoices.
Sometimes you know all invoices you can't find from the files.
Sometimes missing, 2000 year, 2002, okay?
Banks, people changes.
Yeah.
Okay, every 1 year or 2 years, they have a contract. Okay, or they go up countries and all that. But they never pay. They give all the story, kind of stories.
Yeah, but what you do now, you try first to build a case. So, how do you build a case? You get all the problem information that you have. The ones that you have missing and the ones that you have available. You build a case. For example, they might not be LPO. They're the ones who are issuing the LPO. Ask them to give you the copy. If they don't have a copy, how can you have a copy if they're the ones who issue the LPO? If there's email, attach that email. That was this your employee? Is this your official email? Then this stands as order. Look at a business relationship. Sometimes you make orders by calls.
Sometimes you can find the emails also.
No, it's fine.
Yeah.
Go to the delivery notes. We have delivery notes. Just get anything that can show that you have done business with them, even the past transaction.
I give the invoice copy sometimes in a statement. I don't have a delivery note, LPO. Still, the person is denying. Anybody can do the invoice.
Yes, it's very true.
Yeah, anybody, but we are paying taxes on that invoices. You have to keep on the hand.
It is
the
very
line.
True, everyone can do invoice.
Invoice, but the TRA receipt, nobody can do.
And that's what I'm telling you, okay?
With a huge amount.
The way it works, now that will be on credit management. On how do you do your business? How do you start the transactions before it comes to invoicing? But in case that misses, you need to get all the information that you have. If it's just the invoice, do you have the past transaction and do you have past history with this person? How were they ordering? If you have invoice that was paid without an appeal, show them. How come you pay this without an appeal? So you should use the same mechanism to pay this. Like any, further you can tell them that you consumed these goods, they are delivered to your office, and our proof is because you have issued invoice with the TRA signature. We cannot do that if this is fake. This has gone to TRA. So, what you need to do, this needs to be paid. If you're not going to pay, give us documentation why you're not going to pay it. Then we'll take further measures, we'll take further steps. Or if you can't issue a current LPO on an order that was done previously. We had a case like that with NBA.